Previously, I have made a video on the compatibility between the DJI Ronin SE and the Fujifilm X-Stream. In that video, I have made a mistake on the active tracking functionality of the gimbal. At that time, I didn't know how the active tracking functionality worked. And luckily, on that video, I received a few comments which mentioned how it works. So this is why I made this video, in order to rectify myself. The most important thing that you need to do is to attach your phone on top of your camera. And I think this is something that wasn't clear for everyone, that they need to do this. It is not needed to attach your camera to the gimbal. In order to show you how the active tracking works, let me pick up an object which we can use to test. After you have finished setting up your gimbal and your camera, you need to switch on your phone and the Bluetooth. Then, you will need to open the Ronin app on your mobile and connect your smartphone to the gimbal. And don't forget, make sure that your gimbal is switched on before you do this. Next, you have to go to the Create option of the app and click on Active Tracking. You would then see the view in front of your smartphone. In order to activate the Active Tracking, you will need to draw a box on the object that you want to track on your smartphone itself. Once this is completed, you should be able to see a green box around the object that you have just marked. Here you go! This is how you do the active tracking on the DJI Ronin SE. You may want to take note of this point if it was not obvious to you. The gimbal is using the smartphone in order to do the active tracking. So you may be wondering why this is important. This is very key because the gimbal will try to center itself using the footage from your smartphone. And the smartphone is sitting slightly higher compared to your camera. So what it means is that your footage from your camera will be slightly lower than what you would want to. But fortunately for you, I have one small workaround that you can use. It is quite simple, you simply have to put the box on the upper end of the object. Thank you for watching this video, I hope you enjoyed. If you can like and subscribe, that would be very helpful. And if I have made any mistake, don't hesitate to put this in the comment. Tschüss!